little girl growing up in Abonima, I didn't remember my grandmother telling me that they were going to get in the canoe to go to Port Harcourt to wait for yam that they will buy that is coming from the north. No, but today I hear my people say, if they go, how will we eat? How? Yam is grown in Onitsha. How? Yam is grown in Ogoni. We can feed ourselves. Nigeria was an agrarian country. We were feeding ourselves before they amalgamated us. Before the amalgamation, where was yam coming from? Were we not eating yam? Was it coming from Benue State? Or was it coming from where? I see people selling carrots in my community. And I'm asking them, carrots. How much carrots are you eating that will make these people stay here, overtake this community, and selling you carrots and heavens? And you can't ask yourself questions. We must ask ourselves this question. There is no community today where we don't have strangers that are speaking strange language that we don't understand. That we don't know what they are planning against us. And we say it's one Nigeria. No. No, we have to survive. Our communities have to be safe. On Sunday, Christians were killed in southern Kaduna. On Easter Sunday, Christians were killed. It swept under the carpet. Because it's so often now that it doesn't matter. They use everything to cover what is really happening. Money is found in the Ikoyi. It's Jonathan. After 2 years, it's now good luck for Jonathan's money. We have to rise up and take the bull by the horns and say to ourselves, it is either we are men and women, shoulder high, proud people who can feed ourselves and use our resources to sustain ourselves. There is a case going on now. Ijaw people are being hounded for one oil well that is owned by a few Ijaw people together, just one oil well. And yet, in that Niger Delta, over 90% of the private oil wells is owned by people who are not from the Niger Delta. Nobody has taken them to court. And yet, a handful of Ijaw people, just one oil well, they should come and look, either we are prepared to live and stand up or we die. The death is whether we die or not. But we have to choose to stay alive. And when we make that decision, we will see the strength that we will have. Because if they are not mining whatever they have outside of the Niger Delta and Imo, Abia, then they should stop taking the oil and gas that is in the Niger Delta. Why can't we make that decision? We should stop finding solution to the holistic problem that is Nigeria. We should start finding solution to the small problem that is South-South and South-East. We should start finding solution for 20 something states and find solution only for 11 states. Right now, we have 9 oil producing states. And we have one state that generates a lot of revenue. And we have 26 states that are less. They sit down and they collect what is coming from my polluted water. And there is another document here that shows very clearly on oil and gas, the northeast, northwest, and north central is producing 0.00% of oil and gas. I'm not talking about yam. The yam we're buying it is not free. The oil, they're taking it for free. The yam we're buying it. The goat we're buying it. The cow we're buying it from them. Now, 19 local governments, in the 19 northern states, and we that are producing have only 355 local governments. They are getting almost 60% of the oil and gas that they are not producing by local government allocation. By state allocation, they are getting about 58% of what they are not producing. And so when they talk about NDDC, Ministry of Niger Delta, Amnesty, I have told my people, tell them, we don't want NDDC. We don't want Ministry of Niger Delta. We don't want anything. All we want is 100% of our resources. And we pay that to federal government. Those are the conditions. There is no other condition. There is no this way and that way for restructuring. Restructuring is very simply, we sit down and we accept what the 2014 National Conference said. We turn down the issue of grazing meat. What is grazing meat? A man is doing a private business and then he wants to take, he says he owns 80% of land mass. And that Igbo people, Yoruba people, and Niger Delta people own 20% of the land mass. And yet, he's not satisfied with the 80. He still wants to take from the 20. He can't have it. Anybody that is allowing grazing in their state, they want to destroy their people. There's no need for grazing. What are you grazing? There is no reason for that. Anybody that wants to deal in a farming of cow, husbandry, whatever it is called, do it on your land in your state and bring the cow and go and sell it to us. Don't come and tell me that you come. And that was why I was attacked in Bayelsa. Because Bayelsa state government called them and gave them 1,200 hectares of land. Bayelsa doesn't have land. And I objected to it. And I was sent thoughts. My people were picking up and my phone was taken. I was pushed to the ground. But that's all part of the sacrifice that we have to make. But the point we must accept today that there is no look, they said what's a very very to work in work, give me very to fire. They can't kill everybody. Everybody will not die. All the Jews didn't die. Somebody will survive. Our people are in America. One day some of them will come back home. Then we must hold the ground. This is our land. God gave it to us. The resources is our own. It is enough. We have fed this country, Nigeria, for too long. For over 100 years. Civil society is ready and available. There is no point discussing how we'll do it. We've been doing it. We will go down to the grassroots. We're working from the grassroots. But the grassroots needs to know that you are working on their team. And finally, before my brother comes over here, our governors and our representatives and our senators, we are giving them time. We are not against them. We want to work with them. But they must be prepared to work with us. They must listen to what we are saying, what we want. We want resource control and ownership. We want to control our land. Yes, the governor, the right is vested in the governor. But only as far as they use it for our benefit. When you give it to headmen, it's not for the benefit of an Abia man when you give land to headmen. It is not the benefit of the Ijaw man, the Bayelsa man, when you give land to headmen. No, enough is enough. We should rise here with the determination that it is either we are controlling our resources and we're developing ourselves, we're not waiting. opening for anybody. If somebody doesn't want to go to school and my people want to go to school, why should my people be held back? If people want to marry 10 wives at the age of 10 and I don't want my child to be married at the age of 10, why should you come and give us my own? Enough is enough. And the very final warning to us, we should look inward. We should look in our community and ask ourselves, when you entertain somebody in your house and the two of them are speaking a language you don't understand, what are you doing? You don't know what is going to happen to you. So on that note, I thank you for inviting me and I hope that I have contributed.